Welcome to Word of Power. Jeannie and John Alcott are honored to have you be a part of this powerful time with God. We believe He connected you with us to hear this word. You can be empowered and blessed during this time. So allow the Spirit of God to speak to your heart in a personal way. Then believe for miracles. At the end of the broadcast, be sure to share your needs and desires with Jeannie and John for personal prayer. Now, listen for a word of power for your life.
It's so good to be with you. This is Jeannie Alcott. You know how t-shirts are so popular to wear nowadays, and many of them have something printed on them to reflect a belief that a person has. So, if you could print words on a t-shirt which reflected what you were thinking today, what would it say? Would your t-shirt have positive words on it, or would they be discouraged or angry words? Perhaps you've been waiting for something you desire, and it's been quite a while. So your t-shirt would have the words, "Will it ever get here?" You feel the same way as a young college student did. The way they got around the campus was using their bicycle. So they decided they would wear a t-shirt that read, "I'm going to be a doctor." And on their bicycle, they put a sign that said, "I'm going to be a Mercedes." Notice that their t-shirt didn't say, "Will I ever be a doctor?" And the bicycle didn't have a sign on it that said, "I'm never going to be a Mercedes." No, their t-shirt and that sign reflected their expectation. They knew that what they were experiencing at the time would be replaced with something better. They wouldn't always be a student struggling and trying to make financial ends meet and not fulfilling their calling. Their expectation was that they were going to be a doctor instead of a student. And instead of a bicycle, they would be driving a Mercedes. It's so important what t-shirt we are wearing and what signs we put up in our mind. Maybe as we think about our desire, we have a mental sign that says, "I don't think it will ever get here. This will never be better." Hey, God wants to give you a new t-shirt to wear today. It says on it, "This is going to get better." He's giving you a sign to put on that home that isn't meeting your needs. And it says, "This is going to be a palace." So expect a better home. Mentally hang a sign around your kid that says, "I serve God." Put a sign on that hurting relationship that says, "I am happy and restored." Wear a t-shirt that says, "I am free from addiction." In other words, you're expecting something better to replace those things that need change. Put a sign on your car that says, "This is a," and then put the name of the kind of car you want. Put on a t-shirt that says, "I have better health," or "I am well," or "I feel great." Go to your financial account or your investment and write on it, "This is full and overflowing." Put a mental sign on your church or ministry, "Many people are saved and healed." Determine in your mind what God can do and expect something better to replace what you're seeing. He can do a new thing, even in rough conditions. Think of what God says in Isaiah chapter 43. In that scripture, He makes an announcement, and as you hear it, you can imagine God holding up His hands, looking at you, and saying with great excitement and fervency, "I am doing something brand new, something unheard of. Even now it sprouts and grows and matures. Don't you perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and open up flowing streams in the desert." Oh, and it feels as if your answer will never arrive or your desire cannot be fulfilled. Remember, God is telling you He's doing something new. Something better is coming. You haven't heard of it. That's because it's going to be so much better than what you have now. And it's so near to happening that it's already sprouting and growing and maturing. He said, "Even now." That means right now, it's happening. What you desire is sprouting, developing. It's growing and maturing and becoming everything it needs to be. So His question to you in that scripture is, "Don't you perceive it?" In other words, are you expecting it? Recognize it's happening. It doesn't matter how bad the conditions appear. He said He would make a way in the wilderness. Wilderness is rough country where it's hard to make it through. But God is making a way for you to make it through that rough country. And when you hit the desert times and it seems there isn't anything good flowing your way, God will open up flowing streams in that desert. You won't have seen them before, but now all of a sudden, streams open up where they were not seen. He causes things to happen that appear impossible. Behold, He is doing a new thing. so expect something better to take the place of what you see. Now, I want to tell you about a letter I received from a dear partner of this ministry, and I want to read a portion of it to you because the emotions that she experienced and the thoughts she was having relate so much to where we can be at times. But before I do, I want to mention that she starts out her note by saying that she hears the Word of Power broadcast every day. And here's why she does that. She says, to find the new things God is speaking to me through this ministry. So she's expecting new things from Him. She expects Him to show her what He can do in her life. And then she goes on to describe how she was at a point when she felt so much had been taken from her. It was hard to expect that something better was coming. And one day she had to make a trip from one town to another, and it required that she drive up a hill that she had traveled many times. That's where she had grown up. It was a winding road that went around the hill, but because traffic had increased, it had become somewhat dangerous to take that road. So the state decided to change the road to be straight and safer, which of course that's good. But when she came up to where the hill used to be, she said it was completely gone. They had flattened it and made a road straight through. When she saw that, because it was such a fond memory of her growing up years, her heart sank. She thought, one more thing taken from me. I'd always known this hill to be here. It was one of my normal things that I love, and it was gone. So she began to talk to God about how it seemed that everything she had known had been taken. But as she began to travel that road, she heard God say to her, something better will take its place. She knew He was talking about those things that had been taken from her. God was going to make sure something better would take their place. She said her heart jumped and her eyes filled with tears. She held on to that word. When she wrote to us, she said, I know God is taking care of me, and everything is going to keep on getting better and better. My situation has changed so much. God has answered so many prayers for me. Thank you for all you do. You may be at the point that you wonder, when am I going to see something good happen? Remember that God promised in His Word He is doing something brand new, unheard of. When are you going to get to see it? Will it ever get here? I tell you now, it's growing. It's coming to fruition. He's going to make a way when you're in the rough country. He'll open up streams that flow when you're facing a desert. Psalm chapter 30 promises He will turn your mourning into dancing and give you joy. One version says, you did it, God. You turned my deepest pains into joyful dancing. That's describing the emotional pains that you feel deep inside that cause you to be weighed down. You don't feel like dancing. In fact, it's hard to want to go on and just do what you have to do. So God does it for you. And here's how He does it. He reaches into the deepest pains that you have. They are not beyond His ability to get to them. So He reaches in and He takes your deepest pains and He starts reworking and molding. He changes those pains of sadness and lethargy. And He does it to the point that you get up and you dance, as that scripture said. And it isn't describing a passive type of dancing. It's the type of dancing where the person whirls around. You're spinning around in ecstatic praise to God. You can't be still because what you thought would never arrive has come. And it's so much better. It's better than the conditions you have experienced. It's greater than what you have hoped. Oh, the mourning is gone. The sadness has disappeared. You're whirling around dancing, ecstatic, overjoyed. Something so much better than what you were experiencing has taken its place. God has broken past the need and obstacles and difficulties, those things that made it seem as if you would never see what you desired. He's broken past those and revealed to you what is so much greater, and it is now yours. So be in expectation for His Word to be fulfilled. Oh, when God does a new thing, you're going to be dancing. Something better will take the place of what you see now. So rejoice at what is to come. Feel God's Spirit coming to you now. Expect the way to be made and the rivers to start flowing. Expect something new to start sprouting and growing and maturing until it's yours. Our God is not a God to forget what He promises His people. Stand on His Word. Get on your dancing shoes. Get that t-shirt on that says what you're expecting. Hang out the sign that shows what good is coming to you. God is moving in your life. Oh, praise Him. We're going to pray right now as His Spirit is being poured out on you. Let's pray. Lord, You know the conditions my friend has are not acceptable. Therefore, they won't accept them. No matter how much time has passed, we know something better is on its way. So we're in high expectation. My friend shakes off sadness and puts on their dancing shoes of joy. They refuse to go around with a sign saying, "This will never be better." Instead, they're bursting with the message, "I expect something better." And they know it's on the way. They're ecstatic with praise to You because of the joy that's coming to them. There is such great transformation, it will amaze them. Oh, behold, You are doing a new thing, and the way is being made. The streams are bursting forth. My friend is coming out of the rough country. Something so good is bursting forth. So we are in expectation, and we know You will send those good things to take the place of what's been so bad. How we praise You for the new thing You're doing. In the name of Jesus, amen. The key word that God was speaking to you is this: expect. He wants you to expect that something better is going to take the place of what's happening. So get a sense in your spirit of how His Spirit is moving and stay hold of it. That's why John and I are here. We are here at the direction of God to pray with you and be in expectation. We're here to dance in joy with you. So we believe what's been rough is about to get better as we stand in faith together. So be sure to get in touch with us. Tell us what kind of rough country you're in. What do you need to see change or improve? We're going to pray and expect God to do what He's promised. Then we're going to write to you because we want to give you words from His Spirit. They can minister to you. So we look forward to hearing from you. Now I want to give you some faith words. These are words that you can write on a sign or just a notepad, or you can print them on a t-shirt. This is what we call our spiritual power line. Go around saying, "I expect something better. I expect something better." Yeah, tell God that you expect something better, and you know He is sending it to you. He has promised that your answer will arrive, and I want to help you receive it. So be sure to get this entire message that God has spoken to us. Just request the teaching, "Will It Ever Get Here?" And we will send you all five parts of it and the prayer times. Request offer number AM713, that's 713. We can send you a CD for a gift of $8 into the ministry. Or if you prefer to download it, just go to our website, alcottministries.org, and you can get it there for a gift of $5. And don't forget that we're on YouTube now. Just do a search on Jeannie Alcott or Alcott Ministries, and you can hear the Word of Power teachings. Be sure to subscribe. That way you're notified every time a new teaching is available. I can't wait to be with you again tomorrow. This is Jeannie Alcott. God bless you.
Thank you for joining us today. Jeannie and John encourage you to take this opportunity to receive personal prayer. When you contact them, they will lay hands on what you share and pray with faith. Then send you a letter filled with God's Word for your life. You can write to Alcott Ministries, Post Office Box 3400, Broken Arrow, Oklahoma 74013, or call 918-459-9191. You can also receive ministry and request items through our website at alcottministries.org. That's A-L-C-O-T-T ministries.org. There you can also listen to Word of Power broadcasts. Now be sure to request this teaching, and Jeannie and John ask you to join them in giving a gift today to be a part of this great work for God. Don't miss the next Word of Power for you.